السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we shall discuss the event of night journey Al-Isra by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. باب حديث الإسراء under كتاب مناقب الأنصار. Hadith number 112 of Sahih al-Bukhari. The narration about the Isra, that is the night journey by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وقول الله تعالى سبحان الذي يسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. There, Imam Bukhari quotes one verse, verse number 1 of Surah Al-Isra. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحان الذي يسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. سبحان الذي glorified be he who
Allah,
Allah سبحانه وتعالى الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. Who took his servant for a journey by night from Al-Masjid Al-Haram, Masjid Al-Haram, to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. لِنُرِيَهُ الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهُ whereof the neighborhood of Masjid Al-Aqsa, whereof we have blessed. So the neighborhood whereof we have blessed, that is the neighborhood of Masjid Al-Aqsa, we have blessed. لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا for what purpose? لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا in order that we might show some of our signs, or we might show our signs, our ayat to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ certainly, verily, he, Allah, he is the one who hears all things, and he is the one who sees all things, all seer, all hearer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-Sami'u al-Basir. So, here, the reference is to Isra', in which the event in which Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a special conveyance called Al-Buraq from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa at Jerusalem. Well, Masjid al-Haram, you know, it is in
Makkah.
So, a long distance travel and from to and fro travel from and to that is only by a single night. Okay, and from there he was taken to Mi'raj. He was ascended to the heavens. It is called Mi'raj. The hadith. حدثنا يحيى بن بكير حدثنا الليث عن عقيل عن ابن شهاب حدثني أبو سلمة ابن عبد الرحمن سمعت جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما أنه سمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لما كذبني قريش قمت في الهجر فجعل الله لي بيت المقدس فاتفقت أخبرهم عن آياته وأنا أنظر إليه. narrated جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه صحابي سمعت أنه قال أن سمعت جابر بن سمعت أنه سمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول he says that is جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه reports this hadith. He heard Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, saying لما كذبني قريش, that is when the Quraysh, the people of Quraysh, did not believe me or disbelieve me, when the people of Quraysh disbelieved me regarding the event of Al-Isra, the story of the event of the night journey by a single night from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. When they disbelieved in it, then قمت في الهجر, I stood up in Al-Hijr. I stood up
Al-Hijr.
That is, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stood up in Al-Hijr. فَجَلَ اللَّهُ لِي بَيْتَ الْمَقْدِسِ. Then Allah displayed before me Baitul Maqdis, just in front of me. It is far, far away from Makkah. Okay. Still, it was displayed as if it is just before Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then, فَطَفِقُ أُخْبِرُهُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِهِ وَأَنَا أَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهِ. And I began describing it to them, to the Quraysh, while I was looking at it. Okay. Kutumala? Kutumala? Kutumala gane? Dornarda. No, the sharah, the explanation given in Fathul Bari for this hadith by Imam Ibn Hajar al Asqalani. Asqalani. قال ابن دحية جنح البخاري إلى أن ليلة الإسراء كانت غير ليلة المعراج لأنه أفرد لكل منهما ترجمة قلت ولا دلالة في ذلك على التغاير عنده بل كلامه في أول الصلاة ظاهر في اتحادهما وذلك أنه ترجم بابا كيف فرضت الصلاة ليلة الإسراء والصلاة إنما فرضت في المعراج فدل على اتحادهما عنده وإنما أفرد كل منهما بترجمة لأن كل منهما يشتمل على قصة مفردة وإن كان وقع معاً. No. ابن حجر الله أنه explains this hadith. قال ابن دحية assumes that or said that جنح البخاري إلى أن ليلة الإسراء كانت غير ليلة المعراج. ابن دحية assumes that, or he says that, he argues that Imam Bukhari inclined to the view that Isra and Mi'raj occurred in separate Layla, means
nights,
in separate nights. Because what is this, the proof for his argument supporting? لأنه أفرد لكل منهما ترجمة. That is, Imam Bukhari mentions both the incidents separately, Bab al-Isra and Mi'raj separately. So Ibn Dihya says that Imam Bukhari is of the view that these two incidents occurred at different nights, separate nights, separately. But Qultu, I say, that is who? Ibn Hajar. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani says, I say that Ibn Dihya's argument is baseless. It is not correct. You see, when Bukhari mentions about Salah, describing how Salah was made compulsory, kaifa furidat as-Salah, then he, during the night of Mi'raj, during the night of Isra, so Bukhari quotes, Bukhari writes like this, Babu, kaifa furidat as-Salah laylat al-Isra, how Salah was made obligatory or mandatory and compulsory during the night of Isra. So, in Aswala, he describes it. He gives the title like that. So, Waswalaatu innama furidat fil mi'raj. We know, all of us know, but Swala was made obligatory, compulsory during the night of
Mi'raj.
So, here Bukhari quotes, Kaifa furidat Swala laylat al-Isra. How? Salah was made obligatory or mandatory or compulsory during the night of Isra. So, from that we can understand that Imam Bukhari is of the view that both events took place in the same night. Because we know Salah was made compulsory during the night of Mi'raj. So here see, Bukhari says, Kaifa furidat Salah laylat al-Isra. How Salah was made obligatory or mandatory during the night of Isra. So both the nights are same. Okay, follow. Then, no. وَإِنَّمَا أَفْرَدَ كُلَّ مِنْهُمَا بِالْتَرْجَمَةِ لِأَنَّ كُلَّ مِنْهُمَا اشْتَمِلَ عَلَى قِصَّةِ مُفْرَدَةٍ وَإِنْ كَانَ وَقَامًا. That is, Bukhari mentions these two incidents under separate heads only because both are two incidents. Isra is the travel by night or journey by night of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. That is called Isra. Then from there, Masjid al-Aqsa, Prophet was taken to the heavens. It is called Mi'raj. Yes. So both are separate incidents, but took place at the same night. During the same
night.
Now, وَقَدْ رَوَىٰ أَحْكَابُ الْأَحْبَارِ أَنَّ بَابَ السَّمَاءِ الَّذِي يُقَالُ لَهُ مِسْعَدُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ يُقَابِلُ بَيْتَ الْمَقْدِسِ فَأَخَذَ مِنْهُ بَعْضُ الْعُلَمَاءِ أَنَّ الْحِكْمَةَ فِي الْإِسْرَاءِ إِلَىٰ بَيْتِ الْمَقْدِسِ قَبْلَ الْعُرُوجِ لِيَحْصُلَ الْعُرُوجُ مُسْتَوِيًا مِنْ غَيْرِ التَّغْوِيجِ. Now, كَعْبُ الْأَحْبَارِ reports that بَابُ السَّمَاءِ, the door of the lowest heaven, السَّمَاءِ, is يُقَالُ لَهُ مِسْعَدُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, it is called as the مِسْعَدُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, that is the lift of angels, the lift of angels to ascend to the heavens, somehow. Okay. فَأَخَذَ مِنْهُ بَعْضُ الْعُلَمَاءِ. So, from this, some ulama, some scholars assumed that أَنَّ الْحِكْمَةَ فِي الْإِسْرَاءِ إِلَى بَيْتِ الْمَقْدِسِ إِلَى بَيْتِ الْمَقْدِسِ قَبْلَ الْعُرُوجِ لِيَحْصُلَ الْعُرُوجَ مُسْتَوِيًا مِنْ غَيْرِ التَّعْوِيجِ. So, Malaika, angels, used this Babu Sama, Babu Sama, that is known as the lift of angels, as a lift for ascending to the heavens. Okay, and that Babu Sama, the door of the lowest heaven, is facing Baitul Maqdis, just opposite, facing Baitul Maqdis, in the earth, Baitul Maqdis. So, to make the Uruj, that make ascending straight, the ascending was made from that point. So that's why Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was taken from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa in order to ascend from there. Okay, straight, without curve. Okay, that is one view. Now, فقيل الحكمة في ذلك أن يجمع صلى الله عليه وسلم في تلك الليلة بين رؤيتين بين رؤية القبلتين أو لأن بيت المقدس كان وفيه نظر لورود أن هجرة غالب الأنبياء قبله فحصل له الرحيل إليه في الجملة ليجمع بين أشتات الفضائل أو لأنه محل الحشر وغالب ما اتفق له في تلك الليلة يناسب الأحوال الأخروية فكان المعراج منه أليق بذلك أو للتفاؤل بحصول أنواع التقديس له في السماء معنا أو ليجتمع بالأنبياء جملة كما سيأتي بيانه وسيأتي مناسبة أخرى للشيخ بن أبي حمزة قريب العلم عند الله. Now, there are discussions or different views among the scholars, among the ulama, as to why Baitul Maqdis was selected for ascending Miraj, that is for ascending. Why Baitul Maqdis was selected as the point, okay, the launching, starting point. Some opinions are given here. To combine the seeing or sight of two Qibilas, that is, which are the two Qibilas?
Al-Kaaba
and Baitul
Maqdis.
Yes, former Qibla, the first Qibla of Muslims, Baitul Maqdis. So, to combine the seeing of these two before the ascending, that is one view. Another view, as many prophets are buried in that soil, that is Hawla, that is blessed, the blessed soil. It was to have a meeting of the prophets there before ascending or Mi'raj of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with the other prophets, all the prophets there collected, okay, before Mi'raj. We will follow, that is, inshallah, you will see, there all the prophets came there, and Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the last prophet, performed Salah as Imam to them. Okay. Now, also, the merits that he is going to attain in future, that also is indicated by all these events. And Allah knows the best. The correct knowledge, the real knowledge is with Allah. All these are opinions. Okay. Now, وَقَدْ اخْتَلَفَ السَّلَفُ بِحَسَبِ الْإِخْتِلَافِ الْأَخْبَارِ الْوَارِدَةِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ ذَهَبَ إِلَىٰ أَنَّ الْإِسْرَاءَ وَالْمِعْرَاجَ وَقَعَا فِي لَيْلَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ فِي الْيَقَظَةِ بِجَسَدِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَرُوحِهِ بَعْدَ الْمَبْعَثِ وَإِلَىٰ هَذَا ذَهَبَ الْجُمْهُورُ مِنْ عُلَمَاءِ الْمُحَدِّثِينَ وَالْفُقَهَاءِ وَالْمُتَكَلِّمِينَ وَتَوَارَدَتْ عَلَيْهِ ظَوَاهِرُ الْأَخْبَارِ الصَّحِيحَةِ ولا ينبغي الغدول عن ذلك إن ليس في العقل ما يحيله حتى يحتاج إلى طيبه. نو وقد اختلف السلف. So there are difference of opinions among the salaf. So or there is no unanimity in opinion among the salafs regarding بحسب اختلاف الأخبار الواردة. That is regarding the interpretation of the akhbar, a hadith regarding this subject, the Isra and the Mi'raj. فمنهم من ذهب إلى أن الإسراء والمعراج وقعا في ليلة واحدة في اليقظة بجسد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وروحه بعد المبعث. Now, the prominent view is that most of the scholars on hadith and jurisprudence, it is fuqaha and muhaddisin, mutakallimin, they consider that the occurrence of Isra and Mi'raj, those two events, was on the same night. Okay? Same night, one night. And it was the presence of the jasad, the body, and the spirit, the ruh of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there are so many hadiths supporting this view. And many or most of the majority of the scholars, majority of the fuqaha, majority of the hadith scholars are of this view. Okay? That is, the Isra and Mi'raj took place in the same night. And both were in Yaqala, and that is with the body and spirit or ruh of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, there is a prominent view. Now jaa fi ba'd al akhbar ma yakhalif ba'd dhalika fa janaha li ajli dhalika ba'd ahli al ilm minhum ila anna dhalika kulluhu waqa'a marratayn marratan fil manam tawti'atan wa tamhida wa marratan thaniyatan fil yaqala كما وقع نظير ذلك في ابتداء مجيء الملك بالوحي فقد قدمت في أول الكتاب ما ذكره بن ميسرة التابع الكبير وغيره أن ذلك وقع في المنام وأنهم جمعوا بينه وبين حديث عائشة بأن ذلك وقع مرتين وإلى هذا ذهب المحلب شعاره البخاري وحكاه عن طائفة وأبو نصر بن القشيري ومن قبلهم أبو سعيد في شرف المصطفى وقال كان للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عاريج منها ما كان في اليقظة ومنها ما كان في المنام وحكاه السهيلي عن ابن العربي واختاره وجوز بعض قائلي ذلك أن تكون قصة المنام وقعت قبل المبعث لأجل قول شريك في روايته عن أنس وذلك قبل أن يوحى إليه. No, just be noted that there are some أخبار. Now, yes, there are some أخبار or some hadith which seems to contradict this view. That is, Isra or Mi'raj happened in Yaqala, the same night. So, and because of this, لأجل ذلك, some scholars expressed their view that Isra and Mi'raj occurred twice each. Some scholars, some ulama are of this view. That is, لأجل ذلك بعض أهل العلم منهم إلى أن ذلك كله وقع مرتين. Isra and Mi'raj, both of Isra and the, both the Isra and Mi'raj, Mi'raj the ascending. Okay, both of them, both the events took place twice each. وقال مرتين مرتان في المنام مرتان once مرتان once مرتين two times. Okay, so مرتان في المنام one in the first instance or once in manam, in dream, once it happened in dream, then tawti'atan wa tamhidan, that is it was the Isra and Mi'raj in manam, in dream, was just a preparation or paving the way to the actual Mi'raj with the jasad, with the body and spirit together in Yaqala. Okay? وَمَرَّةً ثَانِيَا فِي الْيَقَلَى. And second time, Isra and Mi'raj occurred في الْيَقَلَى. That is, when the Prophet was not sleeping. That is, Yaqala in Unatsi. You see. Kama, that is with his body and spirit. So they combine the hadith of Aisha and other hadith. That is, both the events took place twice. And Imam, one of the sharah books of, or explanatory book of Sahih al-Bukhari. One is this. That is Fathul al Bari by Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. Now, another sharah book is there. Imam Ibn Hajar quotes this. That is of Al Muhallab. The full name is here. Al Muhallab Ibn Abi Sufra Al Tamimi Al Maliki Al Andalusi. He has given or he has ordered one sharah or explanatory book of Sahih Bukhari. And this Imam is of the view that the Isra and Miraj took place twice, two times each. Okay. Now, some scholars say that the Isra and Miraj in Manam or in dream was before the Risalat, before sending the Messenger of Allah as the Messenger. That is before Nubuwat. Okay, before Risalat. Now, some other scholars hold that it was purely in dream or Manam. But this is the most weak or vulnerable view, the weakest view. This is not supported by so much evidence. Okay, now. وذهب بعضهم إلى أن الإسراء كان في اليقظة والمعراج كان في المنام أو أن الاختلاف في كونه يقظة أو مناما خاص بالمعراج لا بالإسراء ولذلك لما أخبر به قريش كذبه في الإسراء واستبعدوا وقوعه ولم يتضرروا ويتعرضوا للمعراج. There are some other scholars combining these two views. That is, إسراء and معراج. Whether it occurred in dream or in yaqala, there are discussions, there are different opinions. And slowly, no. So some group of scholars say that Isra was in yaqala itself. That is, with the body and spirit of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That is, the travel by night from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. That was purely in yaqala. That is, with the body and spirit of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the difference among the scholars is about mi'raj only, they say. That is, whether in yaqala or in dream. That is, the discussion is regarding the Mi'raj only and not about Isra. Isra is confirmed. That is, it is confirmed that it occurred in Yaqla and not in dream, not in Manam. Follow? Yes. Because of this, when Quraysh, Kuffar, the disbelievers of Quraysh, they were informed of Isra, they denied it. So, if it was occurred in Manam or dream, they would not have rejected it. Okay. If it is Manam, going by night, in one night to a distant place, it's not impossible in Manam. Okay. It is probable for normal persons too. Okay. So, they denied the event of Isra only because it happened in Yaqala with the ruh and jasad of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If it was a mere dream, they would not have denied the event. And they would not have laughed at it. And regarding Mi'raj, they didn't deny. These people, these ulama say that. So Mi'raj was in Manam. That's why the Quraysh, Kuffar, didn't deny Mi'raj, because in Manam, in dream, we can go to heavens. It is possible even for the commonest people. Okay. Then. وَأَيْضًا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى قَالَ سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي يَصْوَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى وَلَوْ وَقَعَ الْمِعْرَاجُ فِي الْيَقَظَةِ لَكَانَ ذَلِكَ أَبْلَغَ فِي الذِّكْرِ. That part we shall take later, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.